Today, I want to talk about daddies and sons. What are daddies and sons? They are the young men, meaning their 20s, who love to go out with older men, 50s, 60s, and 70s. My name is Eric, and welcome to the craziness that lives inside my head. It's very interesting because when I was in my 20s, yes, I was really attracted to older men. I think I might mention this in some of my podcasts. I'm 21 and the first guy I fooled around with was 13 and he was 15. Next guy I fooled around with, let me see, I was 17 and he was 20. But when I was in my 20s, most of the guys I fooled around with was definitely 2 to 10 years older than me. Now since I'm in my 70s, I'm thinking, well, I don't know. Because when I was in my 20s, I really didn't bother with guys my age. I always liked the older guys. And now since I'm in my 70s, it's probably hasn't really changed. But I have noticed that there's a lot of guys older in their 50s and 60s and 70s and 80s and 90s that do like young boys. Now, the only ones that seems to be able to have the stamina to be with a young boy are usually these guys that keep themselves in good shapes. I mean, if you go on the Dateline, especially Silver Daddies and all these daddy dating sites, and you notice that the guys who are in their 50s, 60s, and 70s who still work out and still got great bodies and I guess can still get it up want these young boys. A lot of them don't want older men their age or older. And I had quite a few on their profile said the reason why they don't want them that old, because a lot of men, when they get a certain age, they can't get it up, or they can't perform like they did when they was in their 20s. I understand that. And I have come across a lot of guys my age and older who mentioned that it's not so much about the sex. It's more about the companionship. It's more about being held, waking up in the morning in the arms of someone, going to bed at night in the arms of someone. Companionship. And now since I'm older, I'm getting to understand it. I heard about it when I was in my 20s, but now since I'm in my 70s, yeah, I understand that. I understand how passionate holding at night and feeling love is more important than the sex. But then again, I understand that when I was 20. You know, 20-year-old, it's all about sex. And I have to say, there's a lot of guys who still in their older 50s and 67, they still haven't learned their lessons. They still think it's all about sex. The thing that really interests me, that I find very interesting, a lot of guys who get older, and for whatever reason, they have ED, erectile dysfunction, you know, they can't get it up, whatever. Now they consider themselves bottoms, which I don't know, because they can't get it up. They can't be what they call the active partner, and they have to be the passive partner, and now they consider it bottoms. And then I met some guys who got ED or whatever, and they still consider themselves tops. So, again, we're talking about sex. It's not always about sex. And I just want to say, that's why I made this podcast, is that now since I'm older, I'm beginning to understand more and more and more about having someone waking up in the morning in the arms of somebody, going to bed at night in the arms of somebody, companionship, passionate love, you know, doing things together. It's not always about sex.
I think so. My name is Eric, and thank you for listening to the craziness that lives inside my head.